And welcome back to the long run where we're playing Tunic. The last time we died. And also, Fox God isn't who we thought Fox God was going to be. Damn it, Jewel. I'll do that after I'm done my intro. So, yeah, turns out Fox God calls themselves the heir and then killed us. And now the world is bathed in darkness. So, we gotta figure things out here. Us and our little foxy fox buddy. But first, let us have a big ol' stretch. Make sure to include the hands. Because when you're playing video games, the hands are the big thing that will take the most beating. There we go. Sit up nice and straight. And it's off to adventure. Do you wonder if they disappear again after a while? I saw you. Well, you're getting close to something important, but they knew that too. At least it looks like if they get hit, they don't get to disappear again. Yeah, that's what I thought, buddy. I'll shoot you from a distance instead. Works just as well. Let's go ahead and activate this. Smart kitty, sometimes. Also, let's take a look at the manual here, because I think we have a map to this place. Yeah, we do. So those are lost echoes that we're dealing with. Echoes of self that have kind of gone rogue. It's like, you did this. You did this. So, was our power to transcend death granted by the Fox God, or are we just supported by something else now, considering that there are also other... Oh, geez. All right. These birds, they take away max health. Got it. But yeah, there are other dead people here. I wonder what is up with this place. What's keeping us alive? Yeah, there's gotta be something here, just... Where is it? Ah! Ooh. Lucky coin. Good stuff. The speedrun just trolled Fox God to death. Yeah, I'm not surprised. I'm guessing that if you do manage to beat Fox God after getting the 3 bagels, you just get to skip this entire half of the game. Because you're absolutely not meant to beat that. Thank you. Yeah. Just out of bounds everywhere. Okay, it looks like I only, like, I don't take any, like, proximity max HP damage. I only take max HP damage if I get hit by those. Barry. I mean, we've dealt with things glowing purple before, and getting close to those caused max HP damage. Come on. There we go. Tricky bugger. What's over here? Ooh. That looks like a shortcut to me. Anything on the side here? Nothing over here, but also nothing over here. Okay. No prizes. Oh well. Zambas. They don't seem very powerful, let's be honest here. I don't think I can offer anything. One, I don't have anything to offer, and two, all of our offerings that we had previously are all gone. Yeah, that was one of these. Well, this seems like the incorrect path. Hey guys. Come catch me, na 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 na. Oh, that didn't work out as well as I thought it would. Well, one of them got fried. Yeah, these guys also take away max HP though on hit. So I need to be more careful. They're not very fast. But they have lasting effects. Oh. Also, there is a lot of glowy there. Might do us well to put the mask back on. Come on, buddy. Come on. Oh. All right. Saw right through my plan. Yeah, this guy is a little bit of a bigger deal. What's your deal up there? Come down here. I want to talk to you. By which I mean destroy you. Whoa. Okay. My brain was not processing that camera movement for a second. Hey, buddy. That's not quite what I meant to do, but that worked. Picante. Yeah, I think I do have a map of this place. Y'all don't have to charge at the same time. Actually, I think charging at the same time would do me better. This is the map. Oh, three of them. Okay. Back to the staircase? What's at the staircase? Also, I don't see anything here. There's something downstairs? Fight the birth. Yeah, I was doing that, Jewel. You don't have to tell me how to fight. There had to be a shortcut nearby. Actually, let's go ahead and take the opportunity. And attack the statue again. Because if anything else, if nothing else rather, at least we still get restored via the statue. There's a door over there. I don't think there is. Just this one. It's the world I live in, folks. These guys are not slow by any means. They're very foxy foxes. berries. Oh. Well. Hello. What's your deal? Are you the real fox god? Oh, that closed the gate behind us. Oh dear. Concern. At least these are the shamblers. Easy to deal with. Just don't be careless. Oh. Occasionally they wake up though. For a second, at least. Also, the fox, the ghost fox was gone. I did not notice that. Strange how all the skulls are gone. Oh. I don't know what that says, but that is definitely the number 6. I think we're in for an Armos Knights fight. Ah, no. Okay, maybe not an Armos Knights fight, but that's definitely interesting. Okay. It might be Jewel. I am not going to switch it on just yet. Wait, so is this boss refights? Is that what's going on? No. Not really boss refights, it's kind of a game in review as far as enemies. Well, that worked out pretty well. Come to think of it, I should probably change off of the mask. In fact, I'm not entirely sure if the mask actually helped, but it's definitely not helping now. Ooh, that's a lot of skeletons. Ow. This could indeed take a while. Well, let's check out these other ones. Oh my goodness, okay. Okay. Gonna drop art? Nope. Okay. Dang it. I haven't tried you yet. That was a total whiff. Okay, that wasn't too bad. Yeah, that worked pretty well. Oh, geez. Now I'm thinking these guys. Last refill will be after this one. Yeah, sure enough, that refilled everything. If the hearts despawn, I am not sure. It doesn't look like they do. The magic jerks. I don't think I got hit during that. Wanna drop a heart? Nope. Well, we only have one left. Refight of the Garden Knight. Jeez. Okay, there are two of you. Well then, all right. Jewel, I got this. Okay? And you don't necessarily have to shut up, but please don't tell me how to play the game. Turn your back on me, buddy. What did I just say? Ow. Crap. They're too out of sync. Crap. I'm not in a good position here. That's not the one I wanted. Just gonna let a bunch of them spawn in here. Yeah, let the rest of them spawn in. There we go. Phew. If I can deal with these guys now. Gun's a little, oh crap, yeah, it is a bit expensive. Honestly, I should only do one shot. No more than one shot with a gun. Targeting the wrong one. Okay. De-algorithm. Pull one. Oh. There we go. Ooh, all right. Damn it. So what I'm trying to accomplish here is I'm trying to use that encounter to refill my magic, but it is kind of a gamble. Now I'm gonna start with you. Just get you out of the way. That's not what I meant to start with, but okay. I actually wanted to start with the skeletons. With the skeletons. Nope. Damn it. Freaking hell. Like, this place is very much a trial ground. Hmm. Okay. Okay, that actually worked out that time. Although I didn't gain a whole lot of magic. But it's fine, I didn't take a hit either. Damn it. Not really sure why you turned your back to me there to swing, but yeah, you do you, I guess. Let's go to casters. Actually, still doing real good. There we go. Wonder if there is a bonus or an achievement for not using that one. Oh, okay. They stay on the ground, but I can't actually progress until I collect them. Freaking hell. Now I gotta do the whole thing over again. See, I played that Record of Lodoss war game that was done by the same guys as Toho Luna Knights. I forget the exact name, Labyrinth of Deedlit or something. I got to the end, and then they put in a boss rush with every single boss in the game except the last boss. And there's no checkpoints. If you die, you die. You have to start the whole thing over again. And honestly, that just killed me. Like that, I couldn't just not finish that game. I was not interested anymore. I'm really hoping that this won't happen here. But at the same time, this is not as long or like quite as arduous as that boss rush. As I said, the Record of Lodoss war game that was done by the same guys as Toho Luna Knights. I forget exactly what it's called, but it's something along the lines of like Labyrinth of Deedlit or something. Yeah, it had a boss rush. Just before the last boss. A boss rush of every single boss in the game. And it absolutely sucked, and I didn't finish the game because of it. I don't mind optional boss rushes, and Kirby does that all the time. Optional boss rushes, yeah, test your skills after the game is over, basically. I'm fine with those. Required boss rushes. Check, please. I mean, you still get to reach an ending in Forgotten Land if you don't do the boss rush. Crap. Oh, you're talking about Hollow Knight. Thank you. Yeah, like Forgotten Lands boss rush was nice enough to actually allow me to like retry the final boss without doing the rest of it. Hollow Knight's last boss rush is like 40 plus bosses long. Oh my goodness. That game is staying off of my archipelago YAML. Never mind that it has the unfortunate anti-feature right now of if you don't finish the entire game in one session, you have to delete your save file and start over from the beginning, and at least you'll have all of your items back from the server, but still, it's not something that I even want to contemplate. Draw their fire, then attack. There we go. Two bosses, no thank you. I am not down. Frickin' hell. I am having a hard time enough fighting five enemy gauntlets and one double boss without fighting 42 bosses in a row. I think Rao Cao did it, and like he is a friggin' video game hero, let's be honest here. In case you're wondering in which order I'm facing these, like if I'm doing them in like a particular order, not really. I kind of started to for a little bit, but at this point I'm just kind of doing them. Dang it. Okay, who's next? Yeah, the way that this arena wins, for the most part, is not so much power, it just wears you down. Like, on a gradual pace. I just lost half a bar of health here from poor understanding of the controls. That ain't gonna help me. Okay, here we go. get this one down. Okay. I mean, if you just want to stay there and get wailed on, that's fine too. You feel a tingling. Are we the hero now? Is this how heroes are made? Now what though? I got a new item, but I can't actually scroll up to it. It's passive equipment. Does the manual say anything about it? No, you're fine, Jewel. We're discovering right now. This doesn't seem like something that would typically be in a manual, honestly. Yeah, what button do you want me to press? Oh! It changed my role to that. Oh! Welcome to Hyperlight Drifter. We can also do this in the water. It takes a lot less stamina to do. Also, I think, Foodie also used a dash that was just kind of zapping you across. Aha! The power of my stamina has been unlocked. And that's exactly what I was thinking. So now we can get to the hero's graves. And each one of them is going to unlock a different aspect. Oh, see this ledge is a little over us, but we can still dash up to it. This is so cool. Think of the possibilities with this. Okay, well, the possibilities are not necessarily endless, but they are great in number. May not. No? Okay. Go from here. Now, if I can figure out a way to get out of here, and then I can run amok. Anodyne's final skill issue. It's really cool, but it's really easy to get stuck with it. Grave thingies. You mean like. The ones on the right there, or the ones closer to where I am now? Yeah, that's where I am right now. Zapping myself around here, but not landing on anything. Go, like, serious question. Hmm. So I would like to get some exploring done here before the end of the stream. I'm guessing that the solution is probably super obvious, and I'm not seeing it because of how obvious it is, because that's how my brain works. Yeah, Tyrion or Jewel, if you know where exactly I need to go, please feel free to advise. Now is the time where you can tell me what to do, because I have no idea. Jewel, please, don't be like that. Assume the rope you passed while back is the exit. Oh, that rope. Okay. See, that's exactly what I was saying. Aha! See, that's what the game was keeping from us. Again, the same battle, fought uncountable times. Fox with wreath. Crown the hero. Heir to the air. And gets felled by said heir. And then a page on data management. So we finally get a page for the Eastern Vault. And the intro page for the Ruined Atoll. Tells us to activate the four pedestals. Ooh. Unfortunately, it's for a stat that we don't have access to right now. Interesting. Oh yeah, that was hurting us. Never mind. For a second there, I thought it wasn't. I'm not sure why I thought it wasn't. That was a foolish thought. Foolish thought for foolish fools. Another lucky coin. Another one of the hero's graves. Which I don't think we can reach from here. Well, maybe. It's awful dark in here. No sense making that offering right now. And that's a little too high up for us. Excited to see me. Okay, that didn't work as well as I thought it would. Yeah, I do need to actually be a lot more careful than that. These are corrupted creatures. Chomping gnomes. I wonder what the deal with this tree is. We weren't able to come here before we were able to zap around like this. Thank you. Oh, game says no. Why is it so dark in here? So I saw a manual page, which is what I'm trying to get now, but it's very dark. How do I get to you? You know what? Let's go look elsewhere. Interesting that the turrets weren't there anymore. Ah. Ah, and this is telling us how to gain the power of the hero. Some exceptions are no enemies in the dark world. Yeah, we've seen the exceptions. I think mostly there are no like enemies in like the starting places. Maybe? I don't know. What is this? Holy cross. Down, right, up, left, up, right. Oh. Hidden secrets, holy cross, golden path, clearing the game, A, take your rightful place as the heir. wonder if now that I've been selected as the hero, this thing will respond. No? Okay. I want to talk to the fox. Talk to the foxy fox. No? Didn't want to talk? Okay. Yeah, so we got our third card slot. Also, that little sound that played when we got our card slot sounded a little bit like Gradius 3 when you like start the game. Oh, now I can get this chest, right? Maybe? No? Actually, probably not. Oh. Well, we're not going that way. Oh, hi. You're just giving this to us? So it's an addendum to the hints and clues page. Door in the mountains. Hey friend, thanks for the info. Still a little too far for us to What's up, Jewel? Jewel is pontificating. I did get the Holy Cross correct, right? What page was that on? Oh, here we go. pontificating, you're thinking. You're humming. Also, I'm trying to see here, like, I'm wondering if I like follow the arrows. Follow the lines, rather. Yeah, that worked. That did something. Ooh, what is this? Mr. Mayor. Guess it's just an extra collectible, but it's not showing up in there at all. Monopoly Man. Yeah, but now I get how that how those doors work. There is a pattern on the doors. Let me bring up the manual here. So you can see right here. So you start from the diamond right there. Like at the middle, and you go down, left, up, right, up, left, and reach the end of the path. It's a little bit like the witness in that regard. I imagine you can also do the opposite, and it'll work the same because, just same idea, right? Turns out you had the Holy Cross all this time. Yes, indeedy. Anyhow, the door in the mountains might work. I don't know if there was a pattern on that one though. I'm not 100% sure. Bear is investigating if we can get up there anyway. But we are gonna have to do that on our next stream. So thank y'all for watching. Thank you for being here, Jewel and Tyrion. We're gonna go raid Sess. She's still playing what you call it, Jump Hero. Jump no Jump King. Sorry, Jump King. The next scheduled stream is gonna be on it's gonna be on tomorrow. Trying to think of the word for tomorrow. At 4 p.m. Atlantic Daylight Time, it is the Code Creator stream. I'm going to go ahead and exit back to title here. It is the Code Creator stream. We're going to continue working on bumper stickers and Axflixel. Next stream after that is going to be a one-off safe mode stream on Thursday at 10 p.m. Atlantic Daylight Time. So Zero's not streaming that night. We are going to do a few hours of Neon Abyss. Next stream after that is going to be on Sunday at 7:30 p.m. or later Atlantic Daylight Time, our Sunday Super Shuffle. We're going to do some rando shenanigans. And that takes us around the week, around the wheel, to our next long run stream, where we're going to continue our run of Tunic. And we are really underway now with this game. Like, holy crap. Anyway. So yeah, that's gonna do it. But thank y'all for watching. I'm Coolio if you don't know, and I'll see you guys next time.